Good morning, students. Today you are going to have a computer session and we are going to start from the chapter 1, evolutions of computers. Okay, what do you mean by evolutions? Evolution means the history of computers. Students, computer is not a machine which was created very recently. So the computer, when it was created at the very first time, how it was, the size, the speed, the characteristics, and now how the computer has been changed. So the entire development and the appearance, so that is what we are going to discuss, that is called the evolution of computers. So the entire history of computers, that is what we are going to discuss now. And here, these are the points we are going to discuss one by one. Okay, and now let us see the line. First one, we have learnt about computers and their working in previous classes, which means the last academic year we learnt what is called computer and how does it work and all. And now we are going to discuss the evolution, and also before evolution we are going to discuss the different types of computers. Computer means it's not just one type, so many types of computers are there. The first type of computer, so, and one more thing, each computer, all these computers, these all classifications of computer is being used for a different purposes at different places. So that is all we are going to discuss now. The first one is microcomputers, mini computers, mainframe, and supercomputers. So these are the four different types of computers we are going to discuss. And now let us start from the first type of computer, that is microcomputers. So only the name, it's called micro, but the work of this microcomputer is enormous. So this is a commonly used computer, students. And it is small in size, and cost wise it is affordable, so people can offer the money to purchase these kind of computers very easily. And just because a single person can use it for their own person or for their personal work, which means for their academics and also for their entertainment, so in different places these kind of computers are being used. For example, in school, whatever you are seeing, and offices, shops, home. So whatever the computers you are used to see anywhere and everywhere, that is called this microcomputer. Also, it is called as personal computers, PCs. And now we are going to see some commonly used microcomputers. So we have seeing these kind of PC in a regular basis in a different places. But what are the different types of microcomputers? So in microcomputer itself, many types are there. The first one is desktop computer. So I hope you must be knowing it and you have been seeing it for a long time. Desktop computer is nothing but the computer which has the monitor, keyboard, CPU, mouse, these all individual parts connected together, and finally it is called one desktop computer. So which you have which you are seeing in banks, in offices, in schools, colleges, around these places. So the one disadvantage of this computer is we cannot carry it easily anywhere. So that is why it's called desktop computer. And now the second type of microcomputer is laptop. So laptop is just opposite of this desktop. So this is foldable, I mean it's kind of notebook type, notebook computer. So we can take it very easily from any place to place, and it is smaller than the desktop, and there is no additional devices like a desktop, that is no extra keyboard or mouse, which is all given as a different of parts. So like a touchpad instead of mouse, and keypad which is attached in the laptop itself. So nowadays people are so much comfortable working with laptop itself compared to the laptops. And now you are going to see the next my next type of microcomputer called tablet. So tablet PC. So tablet PC means tablet personal computers. So this type of PC is an, it is also called a notebook or a slate shaped mobile. So here you can see the picture. So exactly like that. And it has a touch screen that allows the user to operate it without a keyboard and a mouse. So just like a desktop, there is no mouse needed and there is no keyboard. So we can operate it by touching it. So it is a sensible one. So if you touch it, the screen will understand what is the instruction we are giving to the device to do. And the next type of microcomputer is palm top. So palm top means it is also like a tablet and it is called a small computer, and it can fit in your palm itself. So that is why it's called a palm top, and sometimes it will be comes with a pen. So that is, that works as a keyboard. Instead of a keyboard, it comes with a pen like that. So apart from that, the next device we are going to see, that is handheld device. Handheld device means the device which you can hold it within your hand itself. So that is what it's called, handheld device. And these are very small compared to laptop and desktop and all. And you can carry it anywhere, anytime. It is so comfortable to use. And that is why it's called handheld devices. And also, people can call it as personal digital assistants. Those are called PCs. And these kind of handheld devices are called personal digital assistants. And here we are going to, again under this handheld device, we are going to have some types. So here we are going to discuss some more types of handheld devices. The first one is smartphone. So smartphone, I no need to tell you people, so you know much better. So smartphone, even now the video you are seeing in the smartphone itself. So the smartphone is a handheld device consisting of features of both personal computers and a mobile phone. And we can make a call, we can receive a call, and we can make a video call or just text messages, or we can store a lot of things. So memory is there and we can communicate to many people. So number of usages are there in the single device, that is in the smartphone itself. So except that, many applications like except making a call or communicating with other people, so other functions also there. So that is like a gaming and also translating languages. Okay, so now we are going to move to the next device. Sorry, the next device of hand, next handheld device, that is a game console. Students, I hope you must have played any kind of PlayStation games and all, like nowadays Sony PlayStation is very famous, and Xbox. So these kind of games, so you and your friends or one or more than one person can play at the same time to the same game. So this is called, generally I can tell you, this is a video game player. So which can you can see the visual images as an output, and you can play with the by your own, or you can connect, or you can sit with your friends also. So more than one person can play the same game. So this is only called a game console. So with the help of joysticks and all. Okay, so this is another type of handheld device. And the next type of, and the next one is, finally we are going to complete it with embedded system. In the last year itself, I told, I don't know how many of you remember this one. So combination, any device which combined the combination of hardware and software system is called an embedded system. For example, nowadays we are having almost all the devices or embedded system only. For example, TV and printers, medical equipments. So any device which has a digital display. So these kind of systems are called embedded system. So which means the combination of both hardware and software together. So it can, it is designed to perform a task like accessing, processing, storing and controlling the data in different electronic based system. So examples I just told you already. Okay, students, and That is why, and that embedded system is also called as microcontrollers. So these kind of, wherever these kind of blue color wordings are given, so these questions will be coming in the exam time. So give more importance to these words. Okay, students, and now we are moving to the next type of computer, that is called mini computer. So far we discussed only about microcomputers, and now we are moving to the second type of computer, that is mini computer. So definitely this is a second stage of computer, which means almost all the technologically it has been updated, and if you see here, faster and have good memory and more powerful than the microcomputers and bigger than the microcomputers. So compared to the first computer, microcomputer, so this mini computer has been updated in every aspects. So these kind of mini computers, who are using to these kind of mini computers, means not by a common people. So people who are, people whoever is having 200 to more than 200 computers in the same place. So those people, for connecting all the computers together and for the data exchanges, so those people will be using these kind of mini computers. So examples of these mini computers are here: HP 2100, Microvax 3100, and PDP-8. So these are some examples of mini computer. And the third type of computer is mainframe computers. So students, this mainframe computer is not like the micro or mini computer, because they are very large in size. Size wise also it is very large, and storage wise, the memory wise also it is bigger in size, the memory. And fast wise also it is faster than those two. And normally people cannot go for these kind of mainframe computers. Only who can use these kind of mainframe computers? They are used in big organizations to handle a huge amount of data. So people, whoever is involved to store a lot of data, so the database management people, number of huge amount of data can be stored, okay, so for their future purpose. So those kind of official area people can use these kind of mainframe computers. And for example, here it is very expensive as well, very costly, and it can be used in a large organizations like science laboratories, business organizations, and stock exchange markets. So if you see here, this is all a very big organization. So lot of transaction and lot of database are required. So that is why the mainframe computers are being used here in these kind of organizations, not in a regular basis. So examples also given, that is IBM Z series, PDP-10, system Z10, and these are the examples. And now we are moving on to the last type of computer, that is supercomputers. So supercomputer is, compared to all other type of computer, this is really super duper in everything, because this is the most powerful computers and have a very high processing speed compared to all, even including compared to mainframe. This supercomputer speed is extremely very faster, and it is definitely, of course, it is very expensive too. Very expensive in the sense, very costly. And why, which kind of people are using these kind of supercomputers, means this weather forecasting, defense purpose means the military, navy, so these kind of people, and such as to control the satellites and missiles, and quantum mechanics, so these kind of some extreme level of computational work people, so they can go for these kind of supercomputers. And in India also we have the first supercomputer of our India, one of the supercomputer of our Indian made, that is called Param, and Cray 1, Cray 2, and Sunway, Taihulite. These are the different types of, some examples of supercomputers around the world. Okay, students, in the next video we will see the computer languages.